I don't know if this is going to be particularly useful, but another expression that we could derive, and that I think I'm going to because I'm bored and it feels like I'm leaving it out if I don't include it to some extent, is for projectile motion of this type. We can figure out what the maximum height is, right? That's like a quantity that's just interesting to note, and you can actually derive an expression for that as well. So what is the maximum height that this projectile is going to reach? So one way that we can do that is, well, we need to know what time is it here, right? Our expression that we have, that we kind of wrote out before, that describes where this object is in time, is this, right? It's this change in position, delta y is equal to the initial velocity in the y direction times time plus 1/2 a y t squared, which is always going to be good for any time we have any type of constant acceleration going on. We can write this for any particular direction. We're using y because we want vertical motion. We want to choose that to be y, and we have this a sub y is going to be our gravity, right? Just like it was before. But I try not to plug that in until I'm really ready to start plugging in numbers a bit more. So I try to leave it as general as possible for as long as I can. So the max height, right? We want information about where this object is vertically at a very particular time. So what time is it right here? I want you to think about that for just a second. So I'm just going to let you think. Okay, so the time is, we know something about the flight time. The flight time is 2 times VIY divided by G, and, or, you know, 2 times VI sine theta over G. And that's the total flight time, how long it's in the air from its initial point to its final point. The maximum height occurs when that object is at exactly halfway between its starting point and ending point. Somewhere exactly halfway in the middle, we have the time at which it's at its maximum height. Oops, gotta bump the camera there. So here was the flight time equal to 2 times the initial velocity times sine theta divided by gravity. All right, so what we want is half of that. We want the time to max height. And that's going to be equal to 1/2 of this, or just VI sine theta divided by G. All right. We're going to plug that into here. This is the displacement delta y. So we want y final minus y. That's y final minus y initial. Sorry, I put not sine. Initial equal the initial velocity in the y direction times time plus 1/2 ay t squared, where this is the going to be the max height time as we plug this in. Okay, so we have the initial position. Maybe this is up on a cliff. We want a particular height. We can certainly just call the initial height 0, where it's being launched from. So let's do that. Let's call this 0. So we're going to have y final minus 0 is equal to its initial velocity in the y direction, which we already know is vi sine theta from before, times the time to the maximum height, which is VI sine theta divided by G, plus 1/2 the acceleration, which is negative G. It's the negative gravity, negative because we chose the positive y-axis to be pointing up. And again, the time to max height here is VI sine theta divided by G. And we're going to square that, right? We got to make sure we square the whole thing. I definitely put the parentheses here in this case because that tells me that I'm doing this operation on each one of these pieces. And it's really easy to forget to do it on one, or you do it on one and not the other, and then you always get something incorrect. And I call this YF. I really should call this like the Y of max, right? Y max. That's what I'm solving for. So I'm going to give that a little bit better label in that sense. So let's multiply this through a little bit. We have VI squared. We get sine squared theta divided by G plus 1/2. Actually, take that minus sign. We'll put that out in front here, okay? So we'll make this minus 1/2 G times VI squared sine squared theta over G squared. Something I did here that you may or may not be familiar with, and it's something you should get very comfortable with, is writing something like this, sine squared theta, is the exact same thing as this. You're taking, the order of operation here is that you take the sine of whatever that angle is, and then you square it. It's just written this way in a shorter hand. So make sure that you understand that, all right? Let's look here at our g's. This g is going to cancel one of these g's down here in the denominator. And then we have a common denominator and almost the exact same numerator with just a prefactor out front. So this is minus 1/2 vi squared sine squared theta over g. And this is basically plus 1. This is 1, right? There's like a big 1 out here. So when we take vi squared sine squared theta over g minus 1/2, we're actually going to get 1/2 back. This is like taking, this is like 1 whole pi, and this is 1/2 a pi. And so we take 1 pi minus 1/2 a pi, we still get 1/2 a pi left, right? But now it's going to be positive. Vi squared sine squared theta over g. Okay? And that tells us the maximum height. And we can even check out our units a little bit. What are the units for the velocity? They're meters per second. We're going to square those, so that would give us meters squared per second squared, and we divide that by gravity, which is meters per second squared. Our second squareds cancel out. This meter cancels one of those meters, and we end up, we end up with just a meter, right, which is what we'd expect for a position. All right, so there's our expression for the maximum height that we found. All right. Good luck on the homework. I definitely check out the plane catch example for